And we're back on another video. Let us continue our mathematics series. And now, we will have an introduction sa spherical trigonometry, ang part ng trigonometry na hindi gaanong nadidiscuss. With all that said, ano pang inaantay nyo? Let's go! At kapag pinapag-aralan natin ang spherical trigonometry, ang una nating may encounter ay ang spherical triangle. At para ma-imagine natin ang spherical triangle, let's say, meron tayong watermelon at ginait natin ito sa x-axis, sa y-axis, at sa z-axis. And ayan, ito na ang figure ng spherical triangle. But now, we will focus on sa right spherical triangle. At kung mapapansin natin, ang right spherical triangle is identical lang sa right triangle. Meron tayong sides ABC and angles A, B, and C, which is 90 degrees. At kung ang right triangle ay ginagamitan ng Pythagorean's theorem, ang right spherical triangle naman ay ginagamitan ng Napier's circle. Ganito yan. We will have a circle divided into 5 parts. And from the 6 parameters mula sa right spherical triangle natin, hindi natin gagamitin sa Napier's circle ang 90 degree angle. So meron tayo dito side A, side B, complement of angle A, complement of side C, and complement of angle B. Dito nga pala, sa spherical trigonometry is allowed pagsamahin ang sides and angles because they both have same angle units. Gaya nga ng nabanggit ko kanina, gagamit tayo dito ng complement angles. Let's say we have sine of complement of angle A is equal sa cosine of angle A. Being cosine is the complement of sine and vice versa. At kung meron naman tayong tangent of complement of angle A, we will have cotangent of angle A, which is cotangent is the complement of tangent and vice versa. With all that said, dumako na tayo sa dalawang rules within Napier's circle. Unahin natin ang sin-tan-ad rule, which is the sine of any middle part is equal sa product of the tangents of the two adjacent parts. If we will take the sine of side A, so we will have the product of tangents ng adjacent parts niya. Adjacents meaning yung nasa gilid niya, which is complement of angle B and side B. So now we will have tangent of complement of angle B multiplied by tangent of side B. And then, we will simplify. So now we have sine of side A is equal sa cotangent of angle B multiplied by tangent of side B. Ganon din naman if we will take the sine of side B. And this time, meron tayong adjacent parts na side A and complement of angle A. So now we will have tangent of side A multiplied by tangent of complement of angle A. And then, simplify ulit. We will have sine of side B is equals sa tangent of side A multiplied by cotangent of angle A. Ganito lang ang paggamit ng sin-tan-ad rule sa Napier's circle. And now, dumako naman tayo sa sin-co-op rule, which is the sine of any middle part is equal sa product of cosines of two adjacent parts. At mula ulit sa Napier's circle natin, if we will take sine of side A, we will now use its opposite, which is complement of side C and complement of angle A. So now we will have cosine of complement of side C multiplied by cosine of complement of angle A. And then, simplify natin. Sine of side A is equal sa sine of side C multiplied by sine of angle A. Ganun din naman ang gagawin natin if we will take the sine of side B. And this time, ang opposites natin ay complement of angle B and complement of side C. So now we have cosine of complement of angle B multiplied by cosine of complement of side C. And then, simplify lang natin. We will have sine of side B is equal sa sine of angle B multiplied by sine of side C. Ganito naman ang paggamit ng sin-co-op rule in the Napier's circle. And now that we have discussed Right spherical triangle, dumako naman tayo sa oblique spherical triangle. At kung sa plane trigonometry ay meron tayong law of sines and cosine sa non-right triangle, dito naman sa spherical trigonometry ay meron din tayo niyan. Let us now discuss the law of sines. Ang law of sines natin ay halos identical lang sa law of sines na familiar tayo. And since ang unit ng sides dito is angle units, so now we will have sine of side A all over sine of angle A is equals sine of side B over sine of angle B equals sine of side C over sine of angle C. At ito ang ating law of sines sa oblique spherical triangle. And for this one, meron tayong dalawang forms ng law of cosines. Simulan natin sa law of cosines for sides. So now we have cosine of side A is equals sa cosine of side B multiplied sa cosine of side C plus sine of side B multiplied by sine of side C cosine of angle A. And ganun ulit. Cosine of side B equals cosine of side A multiplied by cosine of side C plus sine of side A multiplied by sine of side C cosine of angle B. And then, sa side C naman, cosine of side C is equals cosine of side A multiplied by cosine of side B plus sine of side A multiplied by sine of side B cosine of angle C. I hope nakuha niyo yung pattern. Ang unang limang function is in the form of sides and our last function is angle. And then, ayan, dumako naman tayo sa law of cosines for angles. At ito ay same approach lang. Lalagay lang natin ng negative sa unahan. So now we have cosine of angle A is equal sa negative of cosine of angle B multiplied by cosine of angle C plus sine of angle B multiplied by sine of side C cosine of side A. And then, ganun ulit. Cosine of angle B is equal sa negative of cosine of angle A multiplied by cosine of angle C plus sine of angle A multiplied by sine of angle C cosine of side B. And then last one, cosine of angle C is equal sa negative of cosine of angle A cosine angle B plus sine of angle A sine of angle B cosine of side C. And I hope nakuha niyo yung pattern. Cos, negative cos cos, sin sin cos. At ang unang limang function naman natin dito is angles. Since ang law of cosines natin is for angles. And our last function is side. And that's it. Ito ang introduction ng spherical trigonometry. Binigyan ko lang kayo ng short introduction sa spherical trigonometry upang maging handa kayo sa next topic natin, which is the main purpose ng spherical trigonometry. At ito ang navigation. I hope may natutunan kayo sa akin. And I will continue on making this kind of videos. At palagi niyong tandaan, never dream for success, but work for it. You may have struggles and difficulties, and it's okay. Because it will be a major part of your success moving forward. So always do things to make you better. And trust me, I'm an engineer.